Hi everyone, my name is Philip Hill. I'm Principal Bassoon of the Midland-Odessa Symphony, and in this video I'm going to show you my reed-making process. Specifically, how I take my reeds from this stage, which would be called a mummy, to a beveled piece of cane or reed or blank with only the wires on and no more string. So, in my last video, I took you to this stage. I soaked the reed, and I scored it and put the first wire on and the string, and I put it on the pin, so we got a mummy. Now, it's been sitting for about 7 days. I actually marked the date on here, the date that I formed it and made it a mummy, because I like the cane to sit for at least 7 days, sometimes less depending on how quickly I need a reed. So I put February 9th on here, and today's February 18th. So it's been 9 days, it's time to open it up. We're gonna take the string off, and we're gonna cut that first wire off and open the cane up so we can bevel it. I just take this string off, unravel it, put it aside. And I've got my pliers. I'm gonna cut the wire off. Grab it, take it off. Make sure we don't damage the actual cane. We don't want the wire to get stuck in there, crack anything or chip anything. Okay, so we take the pin out. Now we've got a round tube. It used to be flat. Now it's sat for over a week and it's formed to a new shape. So there's two reasons why we bevel. And the second reason, which is very important, I did not find out about until very recently. The first reason is so that we can make the two sides, the two semicircles, meet against each other flat, like this. If you don't bevel, they're going to touch each other this way. But then when you bevel, you take it away and then they can come closer together. So I'm not sure if the camera is going to pick that up, but if it does, you'll be able to see. No, I don't think it's going to pick it up. But if it did, you'd be able to see that the two sides don't meet exactly flat like this. They kind of are like that instead of flat. So we need to take a file and sand that down to get it flat. Maybe the camera will pick it up this way. Maybe not. Okay. So anyway, now how far up the cane do we bevel? I bevel 10 centimeters. So I'm going to take a ruler, or excuse me, 10 millimeters, 1 centimeter. So I'm going to take a ruler and I've got a pencil. I'm going to mark on the cane 1 centimeter. Like so, flip it over, do the other side. And then I've got a flat file, flat diamond grit file. You can get this from a reed making store. It's very small. It's super small, fits in the hand. You don't need anything huge. Just something really tiny, because we're working with tiny product. So what I'm going to do, I put the ruler away and I've got the cane flat against the table like this. And then I've got the file flat against the cane like this, and we're going to go across, making sure we're hitting both sides of the cane, both ends of that semicircle at the same time, to make sure we get an even bevel on both sides of the cane. Don't press too hard, don't move too fast, just take your time. We really don't need to take that much cane out at all. You should barely notice any cane coming out. How much exactly should I take out? Well, I like to go up and then back, up and back, and then up one more time, and that should be plenty. So that's what I just did, and then I look at it again like this to see if that semicircle has, the end of that semicircle has become flat. And again, I'm not sure if the camera will pick up this difference. Oh, I think I can see it. So if you look at this one, I just beveled it. You can see the end of it is flat now, like that, as opposed to this side, which I have not beveled yet. And you might be able to see that it is not flattened. Okay, so here's, once again, the side that I just did. It's flat. Okay, so let's flip it over and do the other side. Start. Try to keep it everything steady. So we're going to move up. And then we come back. Again, don't press too hard. Don't move too fast. We go up again. And then back again. And then up one more time. So a total of 5 laps, I guess. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's kind of all I need to get this just right. So then we're gonna put the, we're gonna fold it back together. And we look at, I always look at the end of the tube. And what I'm looking for is for each side to have the same size of opening. Now, I think my eyes are pretty good. If you can't see this, get a magnifying glass and just measure it out if you really want to be that particular. So to me, it looks like one side is a little too open. So I'm actually just going to go in and fix that. Really is not a big difference at all. Just needs a little bit. And by the way, this stage here is why it's very important to score correctly before you do this stage. If you score too deep, you're going to split the cane, and then when you're beveling like this, the cane's going to be moving around as you're moving from side to side, and you might chip off pieces of cane, and then you just have to throw that one away because you're going to get a big hole in your tube, and you can't play on a reed like that. So don't score too deep. Okay, now we have a tube with two sides that have an equal size opening. Let's see if we can find that. So they're a little farther away from each other. Now, we don't actually want that. We've got to sand it down. But also what we're looking for is, and we can also see this side, there's a little opening there. But here, there's no opening. The cane is touching each other. Two sides are touching each other. Right there, there's a little opening. So actually, if I press on this side, we should be able to see the blade open up too. You see it open up? That's one goal we're looking for. Not too much. We just want a little bit of opening. And we want it to be even too. So you can look at it this way to make sure it's opening evenly. And then look at it from the tip, from the blade as well, to see if it's opening. And then look at each side to see if the sides are opening the same distance. If it's okay if it doesn't look completely perfect, but you know, most people that like making a lot of reeds, they're perfectionists anyway. So I think a lot of you will strive for that. Okay, so like I said, we don't actually want this hole here, because then we have a hole in our cane and we might get a leak even if we wrap it in glue or string or whatever it is that you do. So let's take some sandpaper and we're gonna smooth it out. It's such a tiny hole. We don't need to sand. We don't need to go crazy with the sandpaper. Just a little bit. So open it back up and sand like this. I don't know, 20 to 30 strokes, something like that. Again, don't press too hard. We really don't need that much. Blow off the excess just a little bit to smooth it out and get rid of that little dent or divot in the side of the tube. So then we can look at it again, fold it back up again, and it should still open up the blade. It should still, yeah. There we go. It's not going to open it up as much because the tube, the connection of the tube here, this part, is more flushed against itself. So the blade's not going to open as much, but it should still open just a little bit. And then we can take our forming pen, forming mandrel, and put it back together with our three wires. So I'm going to take, I have these pre-cut wires. I'm going to put the bottom wire on first, and then work my way up. Don't wrap your wires too tight yet. Wait until you get all three on there first. Kind of the same way you would put a piece of furniture together, and don't tighten all the screws until they're all in there, and tighten them evenly. So you go around in some sort of pattern instead of tightening one all the way and then putting the next one in and tightening it all the way. Then you're going to warp the wood. Or the same thing with your tire on your car. You don't want to tighten the bolts or the nuts all the way. You want to do them just a little bit, one at a time, and then keep working your way around until they're all evenly tight. Okay, so there's the first bottom wire. And by the way I put my wires on is I just make a cross, and then I hold the reed or the cane, the reed, and the wire with one hand. So I got my finger on it. And then one side slightly longer than the other. I want the side that's longer to be the side that I'm going to take and wrap all the way around like this. So then there's two sides of the wire to cross each other on the same side, on the same side of the cane. And then I get it started with my fingers like that. Then I can finish it with the pliers. Okay, again, not too tight. Just put it on there. And I'm also not measuring this yet either. I'm kind of eyeballing it. I eyeball a lot of things. Once you've been making reeds for a long time, you can eyeball lots of things. But at the end of the day, I do measure pretty much everything I do. I just, to start, I eyeball it. So I'm just putting it on there for now. And then I'll measure it out and make sure everything is in the right spot and nice and tight. So here goes the third wire. By the way, what are my measurements? So I put the bottom wire. Now you measure out the way that is appropriate for your shape of reed. Not everyone should be using the exact same measurements, because if the shape of the reed is different, then the wires need to inherently be in different spots as well. Also, with the mark that I put for where I'm supposed to bevel, that's not necessarily the same for every shape of cane. That mark comes from the most narrow part of the tube, which is not at the base, by the way. It's actually just beyond the base. So I mark right where the cane starts to fan out again to reach the tip. So the narrowest part is sort of at the bottom third of the cane, but not at the very bottom. Mark right there, and then bevel everything below that. Okay, so wire placements. My first wire goes to 3 millimeters, or I'm sorry, the bottom wire, the first wire that I put on, the bottom wire here goes at 3 millimeters from the bottom, from the base. And then the second wire goes to 18. And the third, the top wire, the one at the collar, sits at 26 millimeters. Okay, so let's check that and make sure they're all in the right spot. I need to move it just a little bit. And that's another reason why we don't tighten it too much, because then it's easier to move them if they're in the wrong spot. And we get a nice even tube, so we don't have one part of the tube much tighter than the others before we solidify our position of our wire. Okay, so now everything is in the right spot. Let's tighten it all up. And then after I've tightened everything up, what I'm going to do is similar to when I was creating the mummy. I'm going to take the pliers, the circular part of the pliers, and we're going to put that on the tube and crush the cane again. And we're also pushing down on the pin to really make sure that tube is going to be nice and round and as symmetrical as it could possibly be. So we're just moving the cane all around in a circle. Once again, below the second wire, just like we did for the mummy. We crush the cane and you'll feel it loosening up on the pin. So just keep pushing it down on the pin, down that way. And once it feels like there's nowhere else for it to go, it's probably just right. You're probably going to feel the wires loosening too. So maybe not so much the top wire, but definitely the middle and the bottom. So take your ruler again, and maybe they moved just a little bit. So just take your ruler again and triple check. Make sure they're in the right spot. My second wire moved. So I'm going to move that back up. And I might be able to move it with my fingers because it's become loose from crushing the cane again. There we go. Okay. So that's in the right spot. And we tighten the wires again. I like really tight wires. It just makes the two blades of the cane, of the reed, sit against each other better and vibrate better. Everyone needs a slightly different reed. That's just how I tighten my wires. Depending on the actual quality of that one reed, I might keep the one of the first or second wire a little looser while I'm actually playing on it so it articulates better. But that depends on after I'm playing. For now, really nice snug wires. Okay, so now I'm gonna write on the cane. So the first thing I'm gonna put is today's date. And I'm gonna put that on the tube. And the reason I put today's date is because I want, at this stage, I want it to sit for a month, at least a month, if I can. If I can manage that long before I cut it open and actually start playing on it and it gets wet again, it's vibrating. That just lets the cane sit for a while. I will glue it. I will eventually glue it too. But from this day where I took the string off and beveled it and put it back together, 1 month. I try to glue it as soon as possible, but at least a month after this point. And then I use a numbering system to determine or to show just a prediction of how good the reed will probably be. 1, 2, 3, 4, just four numbers. One means I know it's going to be a good reed. I don't see anything about the reed that makes me think it won't be good. So there are no cracks. It's symmetrical. Looks even. The beveling was fine. My hand didn't slip when I was beveling or anything. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a one. If it's a two, that's because it's probably going to be a good reed, but maybe there's just something slightly wrong with it. This one would probably be a two because there's just the slightest crack in the cane right there, but it's only like 2 or 3 millimeters. So it's not going to be a bad reed. It'll be fine, but maybe that would affect it. Who knows? So let's put a two. A three means that I think it'll probably not be a very good reed. Because maybe there's some issues with it. There's a crack in the cane or something like that. Just maybe something wrong with it. For example, this reed, if you can see, there's a crack up the tube. I think the camera's picking that up. There's a crack in the tube there. So, actually, I gave this one a four. I wonder why I gave it a four. Maybe it was warped or something. But now that it's put together and wrapped in wire, I can't really tell. But if it's a four, it's because there's something really wrong with it. Like it was warped. I beveled too deep. I cracked something in the tube when I was beveling. I couldn't get the blades to sit on top of each other. There would have to be multiple things wrong with it for it to be a four, but it's still good enough to where I wouldn't throw it away. I mean, if I were doing something where literally a piece of the blade just chipped off, then I would just throw it away. But if the blade looks like that and I'm getting a seal on the tube, then there's no reason to throw it away. You might as well cut it open soon and see how it plays. Okay, so that's how we go from a mummy that's wrapped in string to a beveled blank with no glue on it yet. Thank you so much for watching.